We know how bad you are.
Thank you very much. They say you should always be ready. Suji has a tendency to do things like that to the frontline poets. You must be ready. I'm going to do a couple of poems for you right now. I have a poem that I've been working on. I wrote it during Black History Month. It's called "There Is a Celebration in the Nation." It goes something like this. There is a celebration in the nation. There is a celebration in the nation. A celebration of a dark past and a bright future. A celebration of progress and change. Of a people estranged and rearranged. Changed from Mandingo, Zulu, Bantu, Igbo. Tribe upon tribe that struggled and strived from the slave house to the White House. There is a celebration in the nation, a celebration of the African child, woman, and man, stolen from Africa's land, shipped to this foreign land to work for free and to change history. And there is a celebration in the nation. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth, and in the end, God will come again to remove all sin. And for this, there is a celebration in the nation. Today, we celebrate Black history, soon to be African history, that not long ago was nigger history. We celebrate the strength, the hope and faith of the African child, woman, and man, which still stands blessed, bold, and whole. The scars and the pain remain. Many today are drugged, jailed, or insane, but yet we stand, child, woman, and man, proud Black and African.
Yes, sir.
For 400 years in squalor and pain and tears, our nation grieved, yet we still believe. On the testament of Jesus Christ, we placed our life and proclaimed, the Lord is our shepherd, and we shall not want. We shall not fear what man can do. God brought us through with that faith, with that faith. With that faith, the displaced African race marched through a new chapter of his story. Many sung, thousands were hung, thousands cried, and millions died. They were tortured, raped, branded, and some were even de-handed. Yet with that faith, Warriors came in freedom's name. Warriors came. Harriet Tubman, Nat Turner, Sojourner Truth, Frederick Douglass. Thousands of nameless faces and unsung faces fought, cried, and died as in vain the masters tried to break the unbreakable man. In 1865, the president signed the Emancipation Proclamation. And for this, there is a celebration in the nation. There is a celebration in the nation. By their bootstraps, the Africans pulled themselves up like a corpse from a watery grave. The African ex-slave reconstructed his and her life They came with pride and stood.
X, and he's a brother that's been with me, and he's going to say a word, and then we're going to have an open house. We're going to let a few poets come up here before the show starts and entertain us.
Thank you all for coming. Brother, Susie wants me to say a word, so I'll say a word. They beat another brother last night. They beat another brother last night. Do you think it's right because they beat another brother last night? They beat another brother last night. They've got a rope and they've got a tree. But one of these days all people have got to be free. They've got a rope and they've got a tree. But one of these days all people have got to be free. Free? How can I feel free when this is me? Poverty and degradation, the descendant of a slave nation. I took a look inside the white man's history books, but I didn't see me, except when he was degrading me and making sure that I couldn't feel free. Why, he put my great-granddaddy on those auction blocks, gave his son all those hard knocks, and told me that I couldn't have a job because my color wasn't right, and then they mowed Martin Luther King down like a thief in the night. They whipped another brother last night. They beat another brother last night. They beat another brother last night, and that ain't right. Is it time to fight? They've got a rope and they've got a tree. But one of these days all people have got to be free. Or burial grounds will be in demand. Think about it. Think about it. Think about it. Whatever happened to our brother and sister Africans that refuse to accept the slave master's lash and whip? That's right. Much obliged. They killed them. They killed them dead. They've got a rope and they've got a tree. But one of these days all people have got to be free. Thank you very much. My name is Dadesi, and I am a poet. I'd like to share a couple more poems with you, and then we're going to move right along. The next piece that I'm going to do is a poem that...